Hello. I had a whole, and I hope amusing, video all ready to upload. Thank God I didn't get round to it before the news broke. The terrible, terrible news from Las Vegas. With the mounting numbers of casualties, 50 so far, it won't be the last number, I think. There isn't anything to say about the perp because I don't know anything yet beyond his name, but what I do know is that as soon as the enormity became apparent, ISIS took credit for it, saying that Stephen Paddock had converted to Islam several months ago and therefore his actions were religiously motivated, or more correctly, inflamed. Whether Paddock had actually converted or whether ISIS were just riding a wave isn't the point, because not only does it defy civilized imagination to understand what Mr. Paddock thought he was doing, but it lays beyond reason that a group which calls itself religious, which says it takes inspiration from God, can be so distorted in their minds, so vicious in their hearts, so evil in their intentions that they would glory in this horrible act and try to take credit for it, whether that credit was due or not. That takes a special kind of spite. We've seen it before, of course, after 9/11, but it's easy to forget such things because they're beyond our experience. Trump said the act was one of pure evil, with which I think even those who are opposed to him might agree. And the depravity of those ISIS creeps is that they jumped into the situation to spit on the corpses. The whole world is shocked. In my case, I read about it on my mobile phone while I was in the doctor's waiting room. I let out a wail. 50 people! The British tend to be reserved, and in a middle-class area like mine, generally there's some obvious disapproval from the other patients when people disturb the tight-lipped hush of a doctor's waiting room. But my yelp of shock was taken with nothing but sympathy and compassion for Las Vegas and the victims by everyone in the room. We don't know the people, we're far removed from the scene. I'm sure that many in that room weren't even exactly sure where Las Vegas is. But what is terrible for us, as for everyone, is the reminder that the world has malevolence enough in it to cause an old man, for whatever reasons, to end the lives of at least 50 people, mostly young people, I suppose, and that there's enough maliciousness in the world that some are happy to hear of it. I wish peace to the survivors. They're going to have a lifetime of trauma over this, and I wish everyone in the US resolution in both senses of the word.